This is high school basketball on Frontier Community Access Television.
Goes around his man. Nice play by Ben Lowe. Lestoski on a runner is good. A running hook shot. Wow.
Here comes Anthony Peterson. Fadeaway J rejected by Carey.
Comes Lowe, lays it up and in.
Robinson. Three ball is good for Brandon Robinson. Downtown. First.
Carey all the way through. Puts it up and in.
It goes to Lowe. Lowe for three. Good. Spencer spots up. Three and good. Lowe, very deep. Ready, hit it.
Gilmore squares up. Three ball left side and he buries it. Keaton Warren. He's going to take a very deep three. He's going to make it.
Riding through a pull-up jumper. Blocked. What a play by Lowe. Came over and just knocked it out of the sky.
Welcome to high school basketball on Bear Country 95.3. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Good News Gymnasium here in South Deerfield, Frontier Regional, as the Red Hawks take on the Turners Falls Indians. I'm Jeff Terrell along with Chris Collins. Our studio producer tonight is Dave Reno. Turners Falls, Chris, has punched their postseason ticket. They want to finish the regular season strong. They don't want to stumble into the postseason. Frontier just wants to get there.
Well, now it's all about seeding. It's all about, you know, garnering as many wins as possible to get the highest possible seed, maybe host a first-round game. In Frontier's case, they need every win that they can get, and I would think the Turners would be especially concerned because Frontier is starting to come into its own a little bit. They really blew out Athol the other night here. Their offense seemed to be really clicking, and if they can get clicking on offense tonight with the way they play defense, this could get very interesting.
These teams met back on January 5th at Turners Falls High School, a 20-point win for Turners Falls that night. Frontier only scoring 47 points that night, but again, offensively, they're a different team now than they were a month ago.
Yeah, they are, and they really put a complete game together against Athol. Now, Athol is a team that's struggling this year, but still, you know, Frontier has been one of those teams that's really been able to play defense. They play good, sound basketball. Their question has always been the shooting. If they could put offense together, then they'll be in good shape. But Turners Falls also is a complete team. They have great offense, they have solid defense, and of course they have Teon Brown, who's always a threat.
Teon had 21 points in that 20-point win over Frontier earlier this year. But after a 7-0 start, Turners Falls just 3-4 since that time. They come in at 10-4 overall. Frontier at 5-11. We'll take a break when we come back. Introduction of the starting lineups, national anthem, and the opening tip-off. Frontier and Turners next here on Bear Country 95.3.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Frontier Regional.
We better take it here.
Our guests are the Indians from Turners Falls High School. Member high schools of the MIAA cordially welcome you.
And now it is time for the introduction of tonight's starting lineups as the Red Hawks of Frontier hosts the Turners Falls Indians.
Please encourage these student athletes with your personal display of support and good sportsmanship. Now for tonight's starting lineups. First for Turners, at guard, number 10, Tyler Murray Lavin. At guard, number 11, Teon Brown. At center, number 33, Anthony Peterson. At forward, number 24, Kyle Bergman. And at forward, number 15, Jimmy Vaughn. Turners is coached by Gary Mullins. And now for Frontier, at guard number 1, Keaton Warren. At guard number 15, Trevor Gilmore. At center, number 22, Karsten Carey. At forward, number 13, Miles Freeman. And at forward, number 3, Ben Lowe. Frontiers coached by Ben Barczewski. The officials for tonight's game are Corey Dion and Mike Beck.
This has always been a great rivalry in all sports, and of course, sometimes both teams are good. Other times, one team is sort of rebuilding, which is the situation here in South Deerfield. But I got to think, Chris, 20-point game up in Turners earlier this year, Ben Barczewski, again, his team has definitely turned a corner. I have to think it is going to be substantially closer here. Frontier, the home dog still, I'd say, but looking forward to a good game here tonight.
Well, I think it's going to depend a lot on how Turners approaches this game. I mean, as you mentioned, they came out strong, undefeated to start the season. They're 3-4 since then. and they've lost some games that, quite frankly, they should have been more competitive in. Frontier, you know, again, it depends on what they're able to do offensively. That's the only really missing element so far this year. And it reappeared against Athol. We'll see if it can continue to appear against Turner's.
Karsten Carey will be jumping center for Frontier against Anthony Peterson, two young centers, and we're going to see this matchup for the next several years. Corey Dion, the lead official, working with Mike Beck. Ball's in the air. Tip is controlled by Turner's Falls after a brief scrum. Turner's in the visiting royal blue with black and white, and they're attacking the basket on the right. Tion Brown drives the lane, misses with a bank shot, and a rebound by Tyler Lavin, but he walked.
That was a little strong off the glass by Tion.
Now Frontier will be moving right to left here in the first quarter. They're in their home white uniforms with the scarlet and navy. Keaton Warren walks it across the timeline, picked up by Brown. It's man-to-man defense right now by Turner's. 8 minute quarters with a 30 second shot clock. Nice pass down low to Gilmore. Trevor reverse land over Peterson is good.
Yeah, good way to start for Frontier.
Red Hawks lead 2-0. Deep on the right side is Jimmy Vaughn. Gets it back to Brown. Tion guarded by Warren. Couple of little guys. Tion gets it down low. He's in big trouble though as he was going up against Carey. Lost it out of bounds off of Carey. It'll stay with Turner.
Yeah, he's not going to get around Karsten Carey that way.
Carey goes about 6'4". Tion's about 5'5 or so. Top of the key, Peterson. They work at left side to Lavin. Lavin now backs it out. Tion, left wing. Shot clock down to 5. Tion gets it down low. It's tipped out of bounds off Carey. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Tion will inbound in the corner. Gets the ball from official Mike Beck. Throws it into Peterson, right of the lane. The shot no good. Gets his own rebound. Gets it back to Brown from 18. Short. Loose ball on the ground, and it is off Kyle Bergman, and Frontier gets it back.
Good job by Peterson to keep that alive, but Tion just kind of short-armed that jumper, and Frontier takes it back.
Low inbounding underneath his own bucket. Having a little bit of trouble. Gets it into Carey. Quickly gets it to Warren. Keaton running all the way through. Dishes it right side, and a rainbow three is up and no good. Back quickly, Freeman unable to connect. Tyler Lavin beat everybody down court, laid it up and in.
A good hustle there by Tyler to get in position.
Freeman tried to close late, could not do so. We are tied at 2, just underway here in South Deerfield. Coming through, Gilmore on the drive. Off the back of the rim, no good. Bergman clears the board. And Kyle Bergman, maybe for the first time all year, takes it across the timeline. And he assumes his position down low. Peterson gets it back to Lavin. Tyler gets it back to Peterson. Anthony took an extra step. Turnover.
Yeah, well defended again. That was Carey, who just basically made it impossible for Peterson to get around it without taking the extra step.
Inbounding on the baseline again is low. Looking for help. Gets it into Warren. Zips a pass up ahead right in front of us. It goes to Gilmore, left baseline. Pulls it back. Dumps it down low to Carey. Working on Peterson. Comes all the way through. Puts up the shot. No. And a I got screened by the official. I guess
I think it was
traveling
a travel,
call.
Yeah.
All right, so we're down to 6 minutes to play here in the opening quarter. So 2 minutes in, we are tied at 2. Deep on the right side, it's Vaughn on the wing. In the right corner, Peterson beyond the arc. Back to Lavin on the right. Brown, the high post, Bergman. Double team there. Warren and a poke away. And all the way comes through is Miles Freeman, and the lay-in is no good, but a foul on Turner.
Well, that's what happens. Bergman just took his eye off the ball for a half second, and that was all that Freeman needed to steal it away, and he draws the foul, gets 2 shots.
Miles will be shooting off to our left.
A lower scoring game, I think, definitely favors the Frontier Redhawks in this situation.
First free throw is no good, so both teams struggling to get that ball in the cylinder. One more for Miles Freeman. Dips, shoots, back rim, no. Carey gets the rebound, though, back to Freeman. Oh. He tried to zip a pass too much on that one. It goes off of Karsten Carey's hands.
Yeah, good job by Carey to get that rebound, keep it alive, but you got to be a little more careful with the passing there. Once again, every one of these exchanges is going to count for Frontier. They need to be making these shots.
Brown jogs it across the timeline in the front court. Left corner to Bergman, looking for the cutter, can't do it. Passes batted down. Nicely done by Warren. Keaton runs it up himself. Head of the circle, angles to the right, low, beyond the arc. Deep three ball, right elbow is in and out, no good. Comes down to Brown. Turner's looking to run again. Brown quickly accelerates into the front court. His leaner is good.
Yeah, he'll kill you all day with that if you let him.
4-2 Turners, 5-10 to play here in the first quarter. Freeman on the right side. He'll now back it out, gets it back to Lowe. Has it on the right corner. Back near the center court circle is Warren. Right wing, it's low, beyond the arc, and a high post. They go down to Karsten. Carey puts up the shot, no, but two free throws coming for Carey.
See, if I'm Ben Barshevsky, I do that all night until they stop it. Karsten Carey, I think, has a height advantage and certainly has a positioning advantage on Anthony Peterson. I would be feeding that ball down low all night and see what the kid can do.
First free throw by Karsten Carey is good. We are 1 point away from another tie game. Carey will get one more here. Righty shooter, where's number 22, puts it up and in. 6'4 freshman knocks it down. We are tied at four. 4:50 to play here, first quarter. Between the circles, it's Brown. Left wing pass. They're going to the corner now to Peterson. Top of the key, it's Vaughn. They work into the right corner to Brown. Nice ball move for Turners. Top of the key, Peterson. Down low to Vaughn. And loose ball on the floor, and an attempted save by Lavin in the corner. Couldn't do it. It goes back to Frontier.
Not a great exchange there by Turner's. A couple of good passes, but again, they're doing that sort of perimeter point-to-point passing, trying to feed that baseline. It just wasn't going to happen.
Kyle Spencer in for Ben Gilmore. And for Turner's follows, Giovanni Williams checks in. And he will replace Kyle Bergman. And the inbounds pass goes to Carey. Nice pass. Coming all the way through, Kyle Spencer was too far underneath the bucket, lost it, but Lowe picks it up, goes up with the left hand and hits.
Ben Lowe right on the spot.
Frontier with a 2-point lead, 4-2. Lavin spots up for three, right side, book it.
Buried that.
Turners reclaims the lead at 7-6. Lowe on the baseline, gets it into Warren. Tipped away, and it's actually off Warren. Nice D there by Teon. Yeah,
well defended by Teon, or cut Keaton off, and Keaton bounced the ball off his own leg. Break for Turners.
Brown inbounds to Lavin. He has it at the center court circle. Frontier's going to get another new man into the lineup here momentarily. Looks like Jacob Meyer's going to come in, another post player. Pass is batted down. Peterson gets it back. It's stolen away. Loose ball picked up by Brown. 15 to shoot. Teon, head of the circle. Left side pass. It goes to Lavin. Bounce pass in the lane. Vaughn stripped on the way up, but a reach and foul called against Frontier.
Yeah, that was Freeman, and I think Spence got in there. We'll see what they get the call on.
It's on Miles.
Is it on Miles? Yeah.
Yep.
Looked like it was Miles who was closest to him.
That's his first and the first team foul on Frontier. Two shots for Vaughn. First one is good. Lowe checks out. And also Freeman will check out. Meyer, as we mentioned, is in. And Litskoski checks in for Frontier as well.
Ben had a solid game against Athol.
Vaughn's second free throw is good. 9-6. 3-point Turner's Falls lead. Backcourt pressure nearly results in a turnover. Litskoski has it. Trying to get away. He's in a double team. Gets it over to Keaton Warren on the right side. Keaton now will set up the offense. Ooh, nearly lost the dribble. He did. He carried it. No one around him, just lost it.
Yeah, not good. And again, that trap does cause problems for Frontier. They have a tough time getting the ball over that timeline.
3:30 to play first quarter. Turners by three, 9-6. Indians back on the attack. Here comes Vaughn. Gets it back to Teon Brown. Had 3 three-pointers in that loss to Hopkins last week.
Whoa!
And a three-point attempt by Lavin is wedged between the backboard and the rim. It'll go to Frontier.
I'll tell you, it was right on the line. It was right. It was a real deep three by Tyler. And it got hung up by the side of the iron.
Trevor Gilmore is back in. Peterson knocks down the inbounds pass from Litskoski, and Frontier will get it right back. Gilmore in, and looks like Lowe is taking a seat on the bench.
Ooh.
And a steal by Turner's on the inbound. Brown over to Lavin to Peterson from 17. That's an air ball too strong. Giovanni Williams battling for the rebound. He has it, but he's in a double team. He's going to get out of that. Ends up losing it to Frontier. Nice play there by Jacob Meyer. Spencer up ahead to Gilmore, and he's got to take a three from the right side. Trevor is short with that one. Giovanni Williams, the rebound, he got hacked on the arm.
Yeah, a lot of slapping going on down there in the paint.
That's going to go against Trevor Gilmore.
Yeah, I'm not sure that jacking a three in that situation is the smartest thing to do. You really want to work the ball a little bit, set up the half-court offense.
3 minutes to play here. The first quarter, Turner's Falls 9, Frontier 6. Indians have the ball right now. Coming on through from the foul line. Jumper by Lavin. Back rim, no. Gets his own rebound. Loose ball on the floor. Lavin could not save it. Right in front of the Frontier bench. It'll be Red Hawk ball.
Well, Tower's getting a lot of looks tonight early on. And we'll take a little break.
Nick Croteau is in for Turner's Falls. He's one of those guys who sometimes you're not aware that he's out there, but he's stealth. All of a sudden, he'll just knock down a big three. A steal by Teon Brown. Big news there. Does it all season long. Shuffle pass to Williams. Try to get it down low in the paint. It's tipped away by Frontier. Here comes Kyle Spencer. Gets past Teon Brown. Kyle all the way through. In the right corner, he stops there. Passes back to Litskoski. Coming through Gilmore. The floater on the left side is good.
Nice job by Trevor. Got around his man.
Turner's by one, 9-8. Brown top of the key. Goes to Peterson, foul line. He traveled. He's arguing the call,
no,
but
he did
take that extra step before he dribbled.
And again, took his eye off the ball, and Spencer sort of made him take an extra step.
So now Frontier with a chance to reclaim the lead here. They get it up ahead to Spencer. Kyle has it at the top of the key. Stops there. Spins all the way around. Litsowski fakes the three, and they got him with steps.
Yeah. He definitely faked it and took one extra step, as was well defended there by Luke Parsons. Excuse me, by Nick Croteau, sorry.
Jared Muzyka checks in for Litskoski. He'll take a seat on the bench right next to Ben Barshevsky. He has some words of counsel and advice to Ben. Turner's with the ball, 1-point lead, 2 minutes to play here in the first. Teon Brown, a little teardropper right side, air ball, no good. Nice save by Williams, but unfortunately it comes to Muzyka. His pass, though, batted down, and Teon gets it back. Teon going baseline, and he'll bank it up and in.
He's so quick.
Turner's by three, 11-8. 1:40 to play here in the first. Kyle Spencer. Deep pass. Well, finally, they get it down to Karsten Carey, working past Moriarty. Back to Muzyka. Banks a three-pointer. Good.
Hey, you don't see Jared take a lot of those threes, but that time he banked it and made it count.
We're tied at 11. So Frontier hanging right with the Indians. Nick Croteau between the circles. Left side pass on the wing. It goes to Vaughn. Vaughn jump pass right side. Croteau steps up for three, and that shot is no good. Rebound comes down to Kyle Spencer. And again, Frontier with a chance to retake the lead here. Spencer being closely guarded by Brown. He poked it away from behind. It'll stay with Frontier. And Freeman in, and Karsten Carey will take a seat on the bench. Spencer will inbound on the baseline. Gets the ball from Corey Dion. 23 to shoot. Spencer throws it out deep to Freeman. From 19, and that shot is no good. Skying for the rebound, Ian Moriarty. Gets over to Teon Brown. Zips a pass up ahead. Now coming through, that's Chase Novak, a new Turner's Falls player. We'll get to him in a second. He's a freshman. Just called up from the varsity. Ian Moriarty getting it in. Here on the right side is Croteau, lost it. Shot clock down to 10. Novak over to Moriarty. Foul line left. That jumper is no good. Rebound taken down by Meyer. On the pass on the left to Gilmore, up ahead. On the left side, they pass it back out. Freeman kicks it left side, and a traveling call against Trevor Gilmore.
Yeah, a little too much footwork there by Trevor.
Yep.
Again, Frontier's making some good plays, but far too many unforced turnovers.
Craver will check into the Turner's lineup in a rare, in what promises to be a brief break for Teon Brown. He basically plays, out of 32 minutes, he probably plays about 30. All right. Down to 20 seconds to play in the quarter. We're tied at 11. Shot clock obviously is off. Williams on the right side. Kicks it left side to Novak. 10 seconds. Try to pass down low. It's picked off down low by Meyer. 7 seconds left. Here's Kyle Spencer coming through Miles Freeman. Shot at the buzzer. Put up and in. And that's how the quarter will end. End of one here in South Deerfield. Our score on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Frontier 13, Turner's Falls 11. All right, second quarter action now. Turner's Falls with the ball. And Frontier, the home team, with a 2-point lead. When they played back in early January, Turner's led 19-5 after one. So again, a very different vibe, and it's what we expected, Chris.
Yeah, they're starting to come together, and they're making their shots. And again, they missed a couple of pretty easy shots in that first quarter. Could easily be a 4 or 6-point lead.
Turner's coach Gary Mullins said that he was a little worried about this one based on what he's been reading and hearing. Deion Brown on the right side. Here comes Vaughn, left of the lane. Peterson back to Tion, shot clock at 15. Right side it goes to Lavin. Tyler comes in, gets it away to Tion Brown. He'll take a three, he'll make a three.
Not much you can do when you grind it down that far and Tion just makes it look easy.
14-13 Turners. Kyle Spencer gets it away to Miles Freeman. Right side pass to Lowe. Lowe gets it back. Freeman in the paint. Shot is short. Rebound came to Bergman. Here comes Tyler Lavin back the other way. Left side pass. A deep three ball is good by Jimmy Vaughn.
And it spun back through. Vaughn got the roll.
Quick 6-0 run by Turners, and they have a four-point lead. 17-14. Freeman, nice dish on the right side. Spencer, though, can't hit. Oh, check that. That was Muzika. Jared unable to connect. It goes out of bounds.
Well, there's two instances where Frontier had an easy, looked like a relatively easy shot. They just bricked it. You got to make every one of those if you want to win.
Spencer will inbound on the baseline. He's out there with Lowe, Muzika, Freeman, and Gilmore. That's the five on the floor right now. Miles Freeman right of the lane. Turn, shoots, hits from the right side.
And Miles got 4 points this game already.
17-15 Turner, 6:40 to play here in the first half. Here comes Peterson. And Peterson,
oh!
And a nice reverse lane attempt by Bergman. Didn't drop after a poor shot by Peterson, which was well off the mark. Here's Ben Lowe. Muzika, right of the lane, high off the glass, no, but a blocking foul called against Turner's Falls.
Good job by Jared to draw that foul. That shot wasn't going to go. It was way too high off the glass, but I like what Frontier's doing. They're taking their opportunities.
Foul is on Vaughn, his first, team's third. Two free throws by Jared Muzika. Righty shooter. First one is on its way. It is good. He'll get one more. Ben Litskotsky will check in for Kyle Spencer for Frontier.
Three-guard offense on the floor right now for Frontier, it looks like.
One more free throw for Muzika. That one's off the back iron, no. Turner 17, Frontier 16. Anthony Peterson on the left wing. Gets it back to Tyler Lavin. He's running the point right now. Tion is down low. Bounce pass on the right side to Vaughn. Hit a three a moment ago. Gets it back to Tion Brown, shot clock at 10. Tion taking his man off the dribble, pulls it back, launches a rainbow three. That one is well off the mark. And a rebound by Frontier and a timeout by the Hawks. We'll step aside for the break. 5:57 to play first half. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, Turner 17, Frontier 16. Play resumes here in the second quarter. A three by Ben Litskotsky, a Frontier from the left elbow is no good. One and done for the Hawks. Back quickly come the Indians. Nearly a high pass, but it was pulled down by Lavin. Back to Brown, head of the circle. Passes right side to Lavin. Tyler in the paint. Back Tion. Squares up for three. Top of the key is short. For the offensive rebound by Lavin. New shot clock, but Tyler lost it. And a clutching foul is called. And it's going to go against Lavin. Yeah. Lavin can't believe it.
Yeah, what happened was Lavin got his pocket picked and he sort of lunged at Miles Freeman, and that was the foul call.
Lavin, one of the two Turner's Falls players that shaved their heads back in January for that part of that program. For we'll talk more about that moment. Coming back quickly is Williams off a steal. Loose ball on the floor. Nice shot there by Ben Lowe. Got it over to Litskowski. Poked away from behind. It'll stay with Frontier. A couple of Turner's kids, Tion Brown and Tyler Lavin, got their head shaved a few weeks ago as part of the buzz cuts for the childhood cancer recognition. A reach-in foul call. That's going to go against the Turner's Falls Indians. Nope.
No, it's going to
go against Frontier.
It's going to go against Freeman, I think. I'm pretty sure that that's part of the effort that's going to bring Gronkowski here.
It is. That's exactly what it is. So nice job by those. That's going to be amazing to see those little kids with a guy who is 6'5", 6'6", about 250. And a big hit himself is Gronkowski. Three ball missed from the left wing. Frontier comes back quickly. Here comes Lowe, stripped on the way up. A reach and foul call against Tyler Lavin. That's two quick ones on him.
Lavin thinks he got all ball in that one, and not necessarily. And Ben Lowe will go to the line, and they're going to have to get Tyler out of there, which is unfortunate because he's been one of their better players in this game.
This is going to bring Chase Novak into the lineup for Turner's after this first free throw. Two freebies coming up now for Ben Lowe. Spins it. Puts it up. It is no good. Lavin out. Novak in. And one more free throw now. For Lowe. That one is no good. Missed them both. So a squandered opportunity there for the Red Hawks. They still trail by one. Left side, Vaughn, the leaner, and that's good for two.
Yeah, Jimmy Vaughn, that was just a line drive.
19-16, Turner's by three. We're just about halfway through the second quarter. Trevor Gilmore, the paint, puts up a floater, banked it in.
That was a sweet one. That's an unconventional-looking shot by Trevor, but he made it happen.
Frontier back two within one. Tion Brown, center court circle. It's a screen from Peterson. Left side to Novak. In the corner, Vaughn for three. Good! It almost fell off and it just dropped in at the last minute.
Well, Jimmy Vaughn's lighting it up in this half. He's got 9 points already, two threes.
Turners by four, matching their biggest lead of the night. Karsten Carey tried to reverse land through traffic. Couldn't get it to go. Rebound came down to Peterson. Here comes Turners running again. Tion all the way through. The leaner high off the glass. No good. Little out of control. Tipped out of bounds. It's off of Frontier.
Well, Tion hasn't really been having the offensive performance we're used to seeing him have in the first half. But what about Jimmy Vaughn? Out of nowhere, he's just been banking him.
Keaton Warren checks in for Trevor Gilmore. And the two officials are going to get together here now, Beck and Dion. What are we talking about here, fellas? We will never know. As they're done. They get it into Novak deep on the left side. Novak, top of the key, and a reach and foul call against Frontier.
That's going to be on Keaton. I think that's going to be his first.
Fifth team foul on Frontier here in the first half. So still a couple to go before we're into the one-on-one. Tion Brown, left side pass to Vaughn. They jump out on him. Jimmy taking it in. Tried to pass out of a double team into the hands of Keaton Warren. Passes over to Laskowski, who's actually behind his back, but he did a 360 and put it in.
Good job by Ben to corral that pass.
And now a steal by the Red Hawks. Laskowski, a reach and foul call against Turner's Falls. It just shows how quickly momentum can change in basketball.
Yeah, that was on Giovanni on the reach in, but, you know, Frontier, you know, just you think that Turner's is going to start steamrolling, and Frontier comes back, makes a couple of steals and a couple of buckets.
They can tie or take the lead here on a three. Warren passes on the right side. That was the first personal foul, by the way, on Giovanni Williams. Karsten Carey's been quiet so far here. Warren, right side, Lasowski. They go down low to Carey. Goes up, reverse lane is good.
Just as you say, he's been quiet.
22-22, tie game. 3 minutes left here in the first half. Novak on the right wing. Right corner to Williams. Giovanni picked up there by Laskowski. Passes left side. Novak's going to jack a three. That's an air ball. No good. Peterson right there gets blocked by Carey. Tips it out nicely to Laskowski as the youngster continues to impress. Low, right wing. Guarded closely there by Brown. On the left side, Laskowski has it. It's Keaton Warren back to Laskowski. They finally dump it down low. Karsten Carey threw a double team, a triple team, and he hits again.
Yeah, they're putting a lot of bodies on him, and he's making him pay for it.
Frontier by two, 24-22. 2:15 to play here, first half. Deep on the left is Vaughn, guarded by Lowe. Matchup zone defense right now. Tion has it left wing. Shot clock is at 15. They get it in the paint. Williams turns, shoots, banks it up. No good. Tipped around. Carey clears the board as he's become a big part of this game all of a sudden. Keaton Warren now taking it across. Left side pass, Laskowski. In the left corner it goes to Carey. Laskowski, Keaton Warren back to Laskowski. Left side, they dump it down low again to Warren. Loses it this time, and a traveling call.
Yeah, what Frontier's doing, though, I think they're spreading the floor an awful lot. They got Carey going down to the left corner. Then he goes down to the low post, and it really is stretching the Turner's defense out a little bit.
1:43 to play here in the half, and a two-point Frontier lead. And Anthony Peterson will take a seat on the bench. Bergman is back in, and so is Nick Croteau. Turner's looking to tie or take the lead there. They've been a little quiet the last 2 minutes here. Bergman to Tion Brown. Right corner, it goes to Croteau. Williams from the foul line. Giovanni takes it in. Right side. Rainbow three way off the mark by Croteau. The putback by Bergman, no, but a foul called against Frontier. The guys all started heading down court. It was kind of a late call.
Yeah, it's going to be on Meyer, though. And Jacob is not happy with it.
His first 16 foul. Two free throws for Kyle Bergman here. Bergman puts up the first, and it is no good. A couple of substitutions for Frontier. Spencer and Muzika are in. Litskoski will take a seat. And Ben Lowe also will take a break. All right, one more for Bergman. He missed them both. Carey skies for the rebound with those long arms. Coming down to the 1 minute mark here in the first half. Our halftime report is coming up. Right side is Jared Muzika. Here comes Kyle Spencer, foul line right. Sealed off. Jacob Meyer lowers the shoulder. Takes it right through. Blocked though by Williams. Nice play. Ends up in the hands of Vaughn. Now over to Tion Brown. Nice D there that time by Turners. Croteau. They get it down low. Williams through his hands though. Bergman recaptures. Back to Tion Brown. He got run into by Spencer. That's a foul on Kyle.
Should be a one and one here, I think.
Yep. Tion will go to the stripe. Want to thank more of the sponsors on the broadcast tonight. They include Rouse Towing Service, Travel Cuz, and Quabbin Valley Auction. Ian Moriarty in, Kyle Bergman out for Turners. One and one for Tion Brown. Makes the first, he'll get one more. And one more free throw make will tie this game again. Turners is at a lead as big as four. Frontier is at a lead as big as four. But right now, we're right back where we started. Tie game, 24 all, 53.8 seconds left here in the half. Muzika inbounding on the baseline, gets it in to Warren. Heads down court, dribbles through the containment, dishes it to Karsten Carey. In the paint, posts up his shot. Didn't screw up the feet, missed the shot, and loose ball on the floor, picked up by Williams, but it's going to go back to Frontier here.
Yeah, Williams traveled, lost his footing, and so it'll be Frontier's ball.
42.2 seconds left in the half, a new shot clock for the Hawks. Karsten Carey on the right side, somebody got dumped down low, that's Spencer. He's okay though. Muzika over to Warren. Warren. Tricky dribbling with Tion Brown right in his jersey. Goes by Tion. His little teardrop in the paint. A little bit too strong. Carey the rebound. Turn. Shoots. Good. Frontier by two. 20 seconds left here in the half. Moriarty on the left block. Feeds the paint to Croteau. Slithers his way through. Traveling. Craver checks in for Turners. Moriarty will come off. 15.5 seconds left. And Frontier has a chance to take a halftime lead.
Nope.
Long pass. Warren attempted to save it on the sideline. Could not do it. A bad inbounds pass. And now Turners with a chance to tie or take the lead.
Yeah, you can just see that that one was not the right angle and it was on the way out of bounds.
They're going to get Lavin in really quickly for his three-point ability. Williams will check out. He's playing with two fouls, but they want him out there because he can stick that three. All right. 12 seconds left in the half. Left side, it's Vaughn. Back on the wing, Lavin. Croteau, right side. Craver, he's going to launch the three. That shot is no good. 3 seconds left. Spencer, it's batted down, and that'll do it. Halftime here at Goodno Gymnasium in South Deerfield. And our score on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, it's Frontier 26, Turners Falls 24. The Bear Country High School Basketball Halftime Report is coming up next.
Red, money, 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 red
to the Bear Country High School Basketball Halftime Report. We're in South Deerfield tonight. Goodnow Gymnasium, Frontier with a two-point lead over Turner's Falls at halftime, 26-24. Along with Chris Collins, I'm Jeff Terrell. Our studio producer is Dave Reno, also on Frontier Community Access Television here this evening. Chris, when these teams played a month ago in Turner's Falls at halftime, the game was, for all intents and purposes, over. Frontier leads by two. Both teams score 13 points in the second quarter. It's been a, you know, like most basketball games, it's been a game of shifting momentum, but Frontier is looking really, really good. They could be looking even better.
Yeah, I think that this is the kind of game Frontier wants it to be. A low-scoring game, I think, favors the Red Hawks. They're playing good defense. Turner's has made some good shots. They made some not-so-good shots, and Frontier has missed a couple of easy shots, but not nearly as many as they usually miss. See, the difference now is, I think, that their shooting is much, much better, much, much more high percentage. And that's going to, you know, something they're going to have to keep doing in the second half. But Turner's, you know, you never want to count them out. Teon Brown is still Teon Brown. They've still got a lot of weapons. But interestingly enough, there are more scorers for Frontier in the book in this half than there are for Turner's. Turner's only has three players in the scoring book, whereas Frontier has six guys. And usually it's the other way around. Usually Frontier has two or three guys that do the damage, and Turner spreads around a little more, but not the case tonight, which is interesting.
It is interesting, and I'll tell you what's fortunate for Turner's Falls is the play of Jimmy Vaughn. If not for him, they'd be in a little bit of trouble right now.
Yeah, Vaughn's got 10 points, leading all scorers in this game, and he's one of those guys who you know he can shoot, but he doesn't often get the opportunity. A lot of the attention is drawn to Teon and Tyler Lavin and sometimes Peterson. But tonight, when he gets hot, he's shown. When he gets hot, he can really light it up. And tonight, he's been the guy. They're going to need more of him in the second half, and they're going to need Teon to light up. And Frontier is going to keep doing what Frontier does, grind it out, cause turnovers, make the shots when they get the opportunities, because, you know, you don't want to ever miss an opportunity when you have your boot on the neck at Turner's Falls like this.
Absolutely. That is a very good point. 26-24, Frontier is our score here at halftime. More halftime from Frontier coming up after this. Bear Country 95.3. All right, we're set for the second half. It'll be Frontier's ball. They're now moving from left to right, and Turner's will be shooting at the basket on our left. So 16 minutes at least of basketball remaining. Frontier with the ball. They lead by two. Second half underway as Trevor Gilmore inbounds it to Keaton Warren. Ben Lowe on the left wing. Ben gets that left corner, turning, shooting, and that shot up and no good by Trevor Gilmore. Back quickly on, nice block by Karsten Kurion. Vaughn down low. Vaughn gets it back, though, puts it up, no, but a reach and foul called against Frontier. And we'll see who got that foul call. I think it was against Miles Freeman, but I could be wrong. No, it was on Miles. That is his third.
Yeah.
First free throw up and no good.
We're going to get him out of there, I think, pretty soon.
I don't see anybody jumping up off the bench just yet. Second free throw, that is good. 26-25 in favor of Frontier. Early third quarter. Trevor Gilmore, tricky dribbles.
Ooh.
Behind the back, push pass left side to Miles Freeman. Gets it back to Ben Lowe, right side pass to Warren. Keaton holds there. Side pass, it goes to Lowe. The cutter, unable to handle it, was Trevor Gilmore, went right off his hands. Goes up to Teon Brown. Tyler Lavin out there. Lavin has it deep in the left wing. Takes it now between the circle. Shot clock at 20, takes it center court circle, calls out the play. Vaughn has it. Right corner, it goes to Bergman. Kyle looks to get it down low to Peterson. Back to Tyler Lavin. Fadeaway J off 1 foot is short. Karsten Carey gets the rebound. That was an air ball. Gary Mullins, the Turner's coach, put his hands to his sides as if to say, what kind of offensive set was that? Ben Lowe posting up his man down low. No good. Gets his own rebound. Puts it up. No. Tipped out deep to Lavin. Tyler Lavin into the front court. To the line. To the lane. Lefty land is good.
He is so quick. Such hustle.
Nice job there by Lavin. Turner's Falls now takes the lead. Now a steal by Peterson nearly, but Carey ended up with it. Here comes Trevor Gilmore. So, 3-0 run to begin the second half for Turner's. Has them up by one. Keaton Warren comes through the paint. A reach and foul call against Teon Brown. You hardly ever see Teon argue a call, and it's the most mild of protests. He got the explanation from Corey Dion, and then he let it go.
Yeah, I'm not sure he bought it, though.
Yeah.
Even though he got the explanation. That's only his first, team's first.
Now, think about Dion. We figured this out a couple of years ago. He is he's very mature for his age. He's the quintessential leader.
He's a great interview, too, by the way.
Yes, he is. Yeah, he's very intelligent. Looking like he may potentially be going to St. A. up in Manchester, New Hampshire.
Really?
And play some baseball up there, potentially. Hasn't quite decided yet. Free throw good, 27-26. Turner's falls by one. Is Frontier still? Ooh. 3-point bomb by Lavin on left side is good. And Turner's falls goes up again, 30-27 now. They put some backcourt pressure now, but it is broken by Keaton Warren. He's got Lavin right at him. Keaton, tricky dribbling all the way through. Shuffle pass, they get it back. 19-foot jumper is good by Miles Freeman.
Good set there by Frontier.
30-29, Turners by one. Lavin, center court circle. Deep on the left, it's Vaughn, guarded by Lowe. And a high post, it's Peterson, taking his man through a double team. Back to Lavin. Behind the back pass, Peterson jumper from the free throw line right, no good. The ball's tipped out of bounds, it'll stay with Turner's Falls.
That was a slick pass by Lavin though.
And Tion Brown will inbound down the baseline. Tion finally does get it in to Vaughn. Between the circles, it's Lavin, left side to Tion. Wraparound pass in the paint, Peterson backing in. Turn, shoots, rejected by Carey. Back quickly comes Keaton Warren. Gives it up. Gilmore, Trevor, shuffle pass, left side. That shot up and no good by Freeman. Skying at all 5'5 of his height. It was Tion Brown to get the rebound. Tried to zip a pass down low, out of bounds off Frontier. Tribe will keep it. And it's going to be Lavin to inbound on the baseline.
This is one of the more low-scoring games we've seen from Turner's Falls this season, I think, Jeff. They're usually much more up than this.
Do we have a timeout?
Yeah. I think Carey might have some blood.
Yep. So he will have to come off. Jacob Meyer will come in for him, and they're going to get him squared away.
Might be on his hand.
That is a rule. You have to come off. Yeah, he's going to go to the locker room, actually. Oh, yeah, I can see. So he goes out with 4:49 to play third. We'll see when he comes back. Very low scoring game here, Chris. You're right. Tyler Lavin from 15. That is short. Rebound Bergman. Back to Lavin for three. No. Tipped out deep. Comes to Trevor Gilmore. Heads down court. Behind the back. Puts it up in the paint. Back rim no good. Rebound comes to Turner's. Here comes Vaughn. Jimmy all the way through. A little out of control. No good. Tion gets the rebound. Puts it up. No. Rebound to Frontier. Here comes Warren. Cross court pass behind the back of Miles Freeman. He did save it before it went out of bounds. Here comes Ben Lowe. Lowers the shoulder, comes through, rims out, no good. A lot of squandered opportunities for the Hawks here.
Got to make those fall. But it's not falling for Turner's Falls either. So
30-29 Indians. We're halfway through the third. Frontiers has scored only 3 points. And 5 points, or 6 points so far for Turner's, making eight as Anthony Peterson hits to the paint.
Yeah, he went right around Jake Meyer on that one.
Coming through on the right side, Trevor Gilmore nearly lost it. Goes out of bounds. What are they saying?
They're going to say that Dion, I think they're going to say Tion touched the ball.
Tion said
it wasn't a foul, though.
Tion was saying I didn't touch it, and I didn't see him touch it either. Who's closely guarding him. All right, Gilmore has that on the right. Bounce pass, Freeman going baseline off the glass, no good. A lot of bunnies not converting into points. Frontier, they are just not scoring at all in this third quarter. They've only scored three. Turner's has scored eight. Coming through, Tion puts it up off the bank, no good. Keaton Warren gets the rebound. See if Frontier can put this ball in the bucket here. Coming through. Miles Freeman, blocking foul called against Turner's.
Yeah, there's probably three or four shots for Frontier that should have gone in tonight in this quarter. But it's going to be a shooting situation?
I thought it was on the floor.
So did I, but
what's happening?
Carson Carey's back on the bench. Looks like he's going to shoot.
Yep, he will be shooting. He'll be shooting two here. And Frontier has everybody off the lane here for this first free throw. And Freeman puts it up and in. And Meyer is back in again, and Kyle Spencer out there, and also Jared Muzyka.
I think Ben's coming in for the shooter too, Ben Mostowski.
If he makes it. And he does, so Freeman will check out, and Lisatsky will check in. 32-31, Turners by one, 3:08 to play here in the third. In a very tight game throughout, neither team is led by more than four. Tyler Lavin, right side pass to Vaughn. Jimmy, into the paint, jump pass left side, Lavin back to Tion. Anthony Peterson from 19, back room, no, he knew it too. Tried to get his own rebound, tipped out of bounds, it's off Peterson. No, it's off of Frontier. I misspoke, Keith Warren checks in. And sitting down will be Miles Freeman. Lavin throws into Brown. New shot clock for the Indians. Tion, little curl, wraparound pass right side to Vaughn. Jimmy stripped on the way up. Nice steal there by Warren, but taken right back by Vaughn, who laid it up and in.
Good job by Jimmy Vaughn to stay with that. Warren picked his pocket, but he was not to be denied.
34-31, Turners by three. 2.5 to play here in the third. All the way through, Jacob Meyer misses the layup. That's what happened to UMass last night. They lost to URI, a bunch of missed layups. They get it in the paint. Peterson turns, shoots, no good, but a foul down low. Now we'll see when they're going to get Carey back in there.
Well, AP's been having his way a bit with Jacob Meyer in this half, in this quarter rather, and he's been winning that one-on-one battle. Carey's still on the bench.
Two free throws now for Anthony Peterson. First one is good. 35-31, Turners by four. One more for Peterson. It's on the way. That one is no good. So the lead stays at four. Keaton Warren all the way through. He'll lay it up with the left hand, all the way down and in. And now Turner's Falls tried to throw it. Lavin just airmailed it. I'm not sure what they were thinking. Way over everyone's head. It goes right back to Frontier.
Yeah, Turner's Falls is doing their best to let Frontier stay in this game. Just when you think they're going to go on a run.
Tyler Lavin touches his chest saying, my bad. So he's owning it. Warren will inbound on the baseline. Gets it into Muzyka. Top of the key. Fakes the three. They go over. There's a rainbow three. In and out, no good by Kyle Spencer. Here comes Lavin of Turners. Left side to Brown. Tion passes to Peterson. He'll take it from 18. No good. Spencer, the rebound. Looks like young Anthony Peterson is really falling in love with that that jumper just inside the arc. That has not been able to connect.
It's falling in love, but it's not falling.
It's not loving him back. Spencer, side of the backboard, no good. Got his own rebound, but lost it to Brown. Tion's going to take it all the way through. Gives it up to Vaughn. Puts it up off the glass, no good. Can any of these teams score here? Here comes Meyer all the way through. No good. Cleaning up underneath, no good. Unbelievable misses here.
Idiots.
Muzyka fakes the three. He comes through. He banks it up and in to tie the game.
Well, that works.
35 all. Vaughn to Tion Brown, top of the key. Into Bergman. In the paint. Turns. Shoots. Short. Meyer the rebound. Lisatsky. It's kicked around. It's a scrum. Lisatsky gets it away. And the timeout called by Frontier. We'll take the break. 59.5 seconds left. Third quarter. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. We're tied at.
I mean, you can just tell he's frustrated. This has been a frustrating night for Turner's Falls. And with every missed shot, they give the Frontier Redhawks more hope. And right now, it's tied at 35, and Frontier is led in both quarters. Then in both quarters.
All right. Still a low-scoring situation here. Deep on the left side, it's Spencer. Keaton Warren at the top of the key. Left of the lane, loops a pass down low. Shot rejected out of bounds by Novak of Turner's. Nice D there.
They timed that very well.
Yep. Muzyka's shot had no chance. Warren will inbound with 13 to shoot. Throws it to Ben Lisowski, top of the key. Left side to Spencer. Cuts to a double team and a traveling call. Has not been a pretty ball game, Chris. Not pretty at all.
Yeah, Dr. Naismith is spinning in his grave, at least based on this third quarter.
And we're down to 35 seconds, about 9 second differential, shot clock to game clock. Ian Moriarty at the top of the key, looking to muscle his way through, gives it up. Here comes Williams, puts it up high off the glass, rimmed out, no good, puts it back. Rejected though by Lisowski, but a steal back by Craver, and he lays it up and in.
Yeah, Ricky Craver, nice job, saw that opportunity and took it.
10 seconds left in the quarter, Turner's Falls now leading by two. They've outscored Frontier by four. 3 seconds left. And a three-point bomb put up at the buzzer by Warren is no good. End of three here. Goodno Gymnasium, South Deerfield. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Turner's Falls 37, Frontier 35. Turner's Falls outscored Frontier 13-9 in the third. And they take a two-point deficit, turn it into a two-point lead with 8 minutes to play. Whatever team loses this, they're going to think about these squandered opportunities, Chris. No question about that. Each team has had a chance to really stretch a lead.
Well, be truthful, it's more common for Frontier to do that than Turner's Falls. Turner's Falls scoring problems are a little more serious, I think, because they don't usually do this.
Three-point bomb put up. No good by Croto. Karsten Carey is back into the game. He gets the rebound. And Red Hawks get it on the right side. It's Ben Lowe. They work at left side. Trevor Gilmore fakes the three. He'll pull up from 12. Went for the bank. No good. Rebound put up by Freeman. Yes.
How's Freeman making a bid for Helena Chemical Player of the Game right now?
We are tied at 37. Novak. Foul line right. Right corner to Williams. Giovanni double team. He's in trouble. Loses it. What do we got? Timeout called by Turners. We'll take the break. 7:18 to play in regulation. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, a 37-37 tie. Back after this.
Well, this should be a very interesting 7 minutes and 18 seconds in regulation because this is right where the Frontier Redhawks want the game to be, and I think you keep waiting for Turners to turn it up and go to the next level, Jeff, and they just haven't yet. Can they do it this quarter? It'll be very interesting to see what happens.
Inbounding on the baseline with 18 seconds on the shot clock will be Vaughn. Williams now back on the bench. And Craver's out there too. And the pass is tipped out of bounds. It'll stay with the Indians. Vaughn will throw in. Gets it to Lavin. Center court circle on the right side to Tion Brown. Here's Kyle Bergman, battered away. Trevor Gilmore had it on the floor. He's trying to get a timeout call. No held ball. Arrow favors Frontier.
Yeah, I thought he was going for a timeout as well, but that's going to go Frontier's way either way. So,
but the next stoppage of play, it'll go for the Indians. Or the next held ball, I should say. We'll switch that possession arrow. Top of the key, it's Trevor Gilmore. 19 to shoot. Here comes Freeman. Gets it away to Keaton Warren. Try to get it down low to Carey. He does. Carey through a triple team.
Ooh.
Misses. Here comes Tion back the other way. Tion zips a pass left side to Lavin. Lavin pull up pop from 18. Good. Good for two.
He's been pretty consistent here in the second half.
Turners by two. 39-37. Freeman passes up ahead to Gilmore. Tion back to defend. Too strong, comes down the carry, went for the bank, no good. All the misses down low. Frontier though gets it back. Gilmore for three, good! Frontier takes the lead, 40-39. Left side, Bergman. Pass is knocked down, comes back to Tion Brown. Got his pocket pick, nice play. What a play there by Lowe, but they got too fancy behind the back pass. From Miles Freeman got picked off.
I think Keaton Warren might have pulled a hamstring just now. He went down hard in front of us trying to get that ball from Tion.
Yeah, he looks like he's struggling a little
bit.
Yeah, he is. You can see him trying to stretch it while he's on defense. He's guarding Tion Brown, which isn't going to help. Here comes Anthony Peterson. Fadeaway J rejected by Carey. Passes up ahead. Here comes Lowe, lays it up and in. Frontier by three, 42-39. Here comes Vaughn in the paint. Finger roll off the glass and in. Now the teams have picked it up.
He's been an animal tonight.
42-41 Frontier. Here comes Gilmore. Trevor all the way through, lays it up. Too strong, no good. Too much on it. Back comes Lavin for Turner's as the Indians look to reclaim the lead. What a great ball game here tonight in terms of how close it's been.
Yeah.
Not in terms of offensive execution.
No style points.
No. Kyle Bergman, cross-court pass on the right. Lavin, he'll pull it back. Working on Gilmore. Passes to Vaughn. Vaughn, he's going to get called for a travel.
Well, that was
Turner's crowd's really mad.
But that was Ben Lowe that made that happen. Ben Lowe stayed right with him and made him take the extra step. Didn't get anywhere to go.
4:52 to play in the game. Frontier leading by two. Nice play. Trevor Gilmore misses the bunny down low. And now a shoving foul is called down low. Let's see who got it. It was either on Teyon Brown. It's on Teyon. Boy, it was right there, Chris. It was right there.
It was a great exchange between Miles Freeman and Gilmore. All he had to do was lay it in. Crazy.
All right. Warren will inbound. Gets it in to Gilmore. Ben Lowe has it in a high post. Carey all the way through. Puts it up and in.
That's almost indefensible if he decides to go to the basket like that.
44-41, Frontier by three. Vaughn for three, no good. Lowe gets the rebound. And now a reach and foul call against Vaughn as the Indians now. Yeah, they have to get their composure.
Technical. Teed them up.
Yep, they did. Technical foul call, personal foul on Vaughn, and now
he's got to get him out of the game. He's got to sit him down. That might be four fouls on him.
Well, they did post the personal.
No, it's only two. Okay. He's still talking to Ben Lowe. They're still talking to each other.
Free throw is good by Gilmore. Trevor will get one more, and then possession for the Hawks. You don't usually see a Turner's Falls team losing their composure like that. Second free throw is good. Biggest lead of the night for the Red Hawks, 46-41.
Two shots in the ball. This could be a four-point swing.
And a timeout is called by Turner's Falls. They need to take a break, no question. We'll take the break. 4:22 to play in the basketball game on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. It is Frontier 46, Turner's 41. But getting those two free throws, and they made them both. Now they get the ball. They lead by five. Chance to go up by seven or eight here.
Yeah, and Turner's is wasting energy yelling at the refs. The refs aren't the reason they're losing this game by 4 points. The bad shots have been the reason they're losing the game.
All right, Lowe will inbound right in front of us. Guarded by Vaughn, who is still in the game. Now, we don't know for sure if Vaughn was the one that was teed up.
I think it was.
I think it was, too. Karsten Carey. A hook pass over to Gilmore. They get it to Freeman on the right side. Shot clock at 20. Freeman. And a kick on Turner, so a new shot clock for the Hawks.
That's a break for the Hawks, because they were down to 18 seconds on the shot clock.
Now they can reset the offense. After the game, Helena Chemical player of the game. Of course, that will largely depend on who wins. Gilmore 4-3, no good. Ground the rebound, passes up ahead to Bergman in the paint, goes up strong, off the glass, and no good. Tipped out, no good. It'll stay with the Indians as the ball was off the Frontier. Brown will inbound down the baseline. And a foul on the inbounds play. By the way, Giovanni Williams just checked in. It's going to go against Frontier.
That's who they get.
I would say they got Freeman.
I thought it was Freeman. It looked like 1-3. Yep, four fouls on him.
It's four on him. The inbounds pass, Teyon Brown put it off of the Frontier player's hand. It goes up high off the backboard and good.
I don't know what the heck that was. That was bizarre.
He put it in off the Frontier player's back, and then he put the ball in the bucket in a very unorthodox way, 46-43. Frontier by three. Carey going to work. Triple teamed again, banks it in anyway. No problem.
Yeah, 12 points. He's been a factor, huge factor in this game.
48-43, Hawks by 5. Vaughn, Tion, deep three ball. Back rim, no. Low the rebound. Runs it up. Trevor Gilmore coming through, peels back. They dump it down low to Carey. Triple team, kicks it back. Gilmore squares up, three ball, left side, and he buries it.
Wow. Who would have thought this was possible?
8-point Frontier lead, 51-43. They were struggling big time in the third. They got it flowing now. Nearly a turnover. Dipsy to drive, no good by Lavin. Williams the putback, yes.
Good job by Giovanni to stay with that play.
And a quick timeout called by Turners. We'll take the break. 2:50 to play in regulation. And on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, it's Frontier 51, Turners Falls 45. All right, so Turners Falls, hopefully for them, regain their composure here. But they're having trouble scoring here as well here in the fourth.
They're going to have better shot selection down the stretch here, or this game is going to be over quick.
Low inbounds it to Carey. Back to Low as Frontier is able to break the press. Low into Carey. Great job breaking it. Trevor Gilmore has it left side. Nearly lost it. He did. Out of bounds. Too many dribbles.
Yeah, unfortunate.
Turner's going to run up quick. Tion fires it up there to Vaughn. Right of the lane. He goes to the floor. Back to Tion. In a high post, it's Bergman. Right side pass to Vaughn. Vaughn back to Bergman. Foul line jumper. In and out. No good. Gilmore the rebound, and he got bumped by Giovanni Williams. That's a foul on Williams. The Turner's Falls crowd doesn't like it, but it was.
No, it was clearly. I don't know what the argument's about. That was pretty obviously a foul.
Frontier with the ball. They lead by 6. 2:25 to play. Oh, a high pass into Carey. Good job of pulling it down. Here comes Low. Kicks it right side. Jacob Meyer. Traveling violation as he up faked and then took a step.
Yeah, I'd be looking at Carey every time down the floor in the paint. They've had no answer for him in the middle tonight.
No, they have not. And just keep doing it. Keep doing it. Keep doing it. Right side, Vaughn. Top of the key, Tion feeds it to Bergman. Right side, they get it back. Tion, a deep three, top of the key. It is no good. Jacob Meyer the rebound, but his pass got picked up by Bergman to Williams. Rejected by Gilmore, but a foul.
Well, good job by Gilmore to get back there, but again, you got to protect the basketball better than that. You're hanging on to a 6-point lead with less than 2 to play. You don't want to be giving these guys free shots.
I think Mully wants to get Peterson back in, not just yet. Free throw is good. Meyer out. Miles Freeman in with 4 fouls right now. One more, he would be done. One more for Williams. That one is short. 51-46. In favor of Frontier, they lead by 5, 1:50 to play in the game. Gilmore passes right corner. Get it on the wing. Back to Low. Quickly double team. Then Low. Passes left side, Keaton Warren. He's going to take a very deep three. He's going to make it!
That's not usually a shot Keaton Warren takes, but that time, big bucket.
The lead for Frontier is 8, 54-46. Tion Brown, left side pass to Vaughn. Jimmy Vaughn, pass is stolen by Warren, and then Lavin grabbed his jersey before he could break away. That's not a bad foul.
That should be Ben Barshevsky's trying to call a deliberate foul. It's going to be a 1-on-1. It's not going to be a deliberate foul. That would have been 2 shots.
He did grab the jersey, but didn't really hang on. Just enough to get called for a foul. There we have another timeout on the floor. This one is charged to Frontier. 1:18 to play. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Frontier 54, Turner's Falls 46.
These are big shots right here. This is a 1-on-1 situation. And 2, and he makes both of them. It's going to be awful tough to come back 10 points down with a minute 18 left.
Yeah, especially with the way Turner's Falls has struggled shooting the ball tonight. All right. Keaton Warren, 1-1. First one is no good. Deep rebound to Lavin. So a bit of a reprieve for Turners. at least for now. Very deep three by Lavin, and is good, and a quick timeout called by Turner. That was way out there. We'll take the break. 1:10 left to play. We're not done yet. Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, Frontier 54, Turner's 49.
He's been, I think, arguably the best player for Turner's Falls. I think Jimmy Vaughn's in the conversation. If they would come back and win this game for player of the game, it's been a tough night for Turner's in terms of shooting. Teon's been pretty quiet, 11 points, but Lavin and Vaughn have been the guys who have kept Turner's in this game, I think, largely.
All right, Turner's will settle into half-court offense. Keaton Warren will take it across. Frontier leading by five. Here's Benlow, double teamed over to Warren. Reaching, foul call on Williams. He's jumping around. He wanted to get a clean pick, didn't get it. That's eight fouls. It's 1-1 for Keaton Warren. That's three personals, by the way, on Williams. He will check out here.
Lots of subs coming in here.
Yeah, well, Mully's getting offense for defense. He's got Craver who can shoot the three. He's got Vaughn who clearly can. And also Croto, who's a good three-point shooter. And the big guys take a seat on the bench. Warren, first of the 1-1 is good. That makes it a six-point game. One more make, and it's a three-possession game with 59.7 seconds left. So this is huge here. This could make it a three-possession game. It's on the way. No good. The lead is six. 55-49, 55 seconds left. Craver, left wing, three ball, short. Comes to Trevor Gilmore. Chasing the backcourt. Turner's now double-teaming. Teon goes for the steal. Foul call. We are shooting, that's the ninth team foul, so we're still 1-1 with Frontier leading by six. And it's Keaton Warren again at the line. Warren had that big three a moment ago. Made one of two a moment ago. All right, front end of the 1-1. Let's it fly, good. 56-49, so it's a seven-point lead. That means three possessions for Turner's. They are right up against it now. Second free one is no good. Freeman, though, gets the rebound, and Turner's at the foul again right now. They don't get the foul right away. They got a foul here. They go down low to Carey. He puts it up and in.
That might have been the backbreaker right there.
The lead is 9, 58-49 with 30 seconds left. Lavin puts up a three, misses badly. Loose ball out of bounds. It'll go to Frontier.
Well, you said at the beginning, Jeff, and you're absolutely right, and Gary Mullins almost predicted this. He said he was scared about this one, and he should be. Frontier has played probably the game of the season so far. Despite all the misses, they've been doing everything else right, and it just has not been Turner's Falls night.
Inbounding on the baseline is low. Only 28 seconds left. Into Warren. Boy, a lot of contact. We lost it out of bounds. It goes to Turner's. Wow. Okay, it's going to be Indian ball.
A great deal of contact.
No foul call. No big argument from Ben Barshevsky, though. They alley-oop it over left side to Craver. Teon Brown, very deep three. That is good. And a quick timeout called by Turner's. Hold the phone. It's still a long shot, but it's a two-possession game with 18 seconds left to play. Our score, Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard, Frontier 58, Turner's 52 with 18.4 seconds left. This is Bear Country 95.3. All right, Turner's Falls comes out with Lavin, Brown, obviously, Bergman, Williams, and Peterson. That's the five on the floor. As they will get a quick foul here. Frontier comes out with Gilmore, Lowe, Carey, Keaton Warren's out there, and Miles Freeman. They get it in, nearly a steal there, but they do get it in to Trevor Gilmore. He gets fouled, 14.4 seconds left, and now we're into two shots.
And the sixth man is pretty sure it's over.
Yeah, they did. They warm up the bus chant a moment ago, and I thought, you might want to hold off on that just a bit. Turner's is going to get their shooters back in after this first free throw. Williams and Peterson and Bergman will come off. And they are going to get Vaughn, Proto, and Craver back in. First free throw by Gilmore is good. Well, that makes it a three-possession game again. So, it's, for all intents and purposes, it's over.
Gilmore's had a pretty good, pretty monster game tonight, 15 points.
One more for Trevor. So the Red Hawks are going to get the W. This is what we call a quality win. This isn't Athol or Smith. This is Turner's. Tournament-bound team. Free throw is good. 60-52 now. Tion gets it left side. Lavin for three. No good. Tion gets the rebound. He's going to go back for three. Fadeaway three is short. 3 seconds left to Karsten Curie. And that'll do it. Frontier Red Hawks with a 60-52 victory over the Turner's Falls Indians. Very impressive fourth quarter. They were really struggling there in the third, but they end up winning it by eight. We'll take a timeout. The Bear Country High School basketball postgame report coming up next on Bear Country 95.3. And we are back here at Goodnow Gymnasium in South Deerfield, the Frontier Red Hawks, with a nice 25-point burst in that fourth quarter. They came back from a two-point deficit at the end of three. They win it by eight, 60-52 over the Turner's Falls Indians. Jeff Terrell, Chris Collins here courtside. Dave Reno, our studio producer. Some people may say, I suggested it earlier, winning ugly, but you know what? They will take the W. They played well, and really at the end, it was not an ugly win. That fourth quarter, they were very impressive, Chris.
No, and it was the biggest win of the year, I think, for this team. And they, like you said, they've been coming on recently, and you know they beat up on Athol pretty good. You figure, well, it's Athol. You know, they've only won one game. There's no question that they beat a better team tonight. I mean, in terms of record and everything else. I mean, Turner's Falls did not have the shooting game they're used to having, and it was an uneven performance, but Frontier was not uneven. They played strong defense. Yeah, there were moments where it was a little bit ragged, but, you know, 60 points against a quality Turner's Falls team, you can't ask for much better than that.
Yeah, on a night when you really didn't shoot the ball that well, but they do need to lock some things up here as we head into the home stretch of the season. Just a couple of weeks left in the regular season. A lot of bunnies missed by the Red Hawks.
Yeah, but that's been happening all year. But, you know, they made more than they missed. And, you know, you can say they should be shooting better. This team was never really billed as a shoot-the-lights-out kind of a team. They haven't had consistent shooting for the last couple of seasons. But what they do play is strong defense, and they really cause problems for Turner's Falls. Turner's Falls missed a lot of shots, but they missed shots because they were heavily defended. And I think you put that together with the post play of Karsten Carey, and it's a formula for a win. This is a team that's going to make some noise before this season is done, and they may very well end up in that tournament if they can keep going and keep winning down the stretch.
On the other side, Chris, for Turner's Falls, again, they're still a good basketball team, but they're a good basketball team that's gone 3-5 over their last eight games after that 7-0 start.
Yeah, it's one of those situations where, you know, you're not quite sure what's going on. You know, is it a mental thing? Is it just one of those deals where you've got just inconsistent play, or is there something larger happening? They still got great talent, and I think that they miss Josh Obachowski. I think that losing him and has been an issue for them. And I think that that's one of the factors that could be playing into this. But Tion Brown, you know, he had 14 points in that, but it was a quiet 14. It wasn't a Tion Brown-like performance. Yeah. And whatever the problem is, whether it's mental or physical or just operational, Turner's got to figure it out because they're going to have a big bullseye on their back when they go to the playoffs.
Yeah, you don't want to be stumbling into the postseason because you will be one and done almost right for sure because, you know, by definition, you'll be playing a quality opponent and your season will be over. And it'd be a shame, especially for the seniors. Okay, we'll wrap up our coverage here in a minute with the Helena Chemical Player of the Game, but Chris will run those final numbers.
Okay, for the Turner's Falls Indians, Jimmy Vaughn and Tyler Lavin lead all scorers. Well, actually, their scorers with 15 points. 14, as I mentioned, for Tion Brown. 3 for Giovanni Williams, who played, I thought, pretty well down the stretch. 3 points for Anthony Peterson. And 2 for Ricky Craver for the Frontier Redhawks. 16 points for Trevor Gilmore.
14 for Karsten Carey, 11 for Miles Freeman, 8 for Keaton Warren, all in the second half, and a big three-pointer among those. 6 for Jared Muzica, 4 for Ben Lowe, and 2 for Ben Listowski. 60-52 is the final. Red Hawks win.
Well, I tell you, Ben Barshevsky has to be happy. I'll throw two more numbers out. 9 points in the third, 25 in the fourth. They made big free throws down the stretch. Boy, something definitely to build on there for the Frontier Redhawks. No question about that. All right, time now for the Helena Chemical Player of the Game. It will come from the home team, and we're going to go with the big guy down low, number 22, Karsten Carey.
Yeah, with all due respect to Trevor Gilmore, who had a great game. Miles had a good game. Keaton Warren had a spectacular game, especially in the second half. But we got to give it to Karsten Carey, because when Karsten Carey gets the ball in the paint, he's very, very hard to stop. And there just was no answer for him tonight. And he came up big with a couple of blocks. He definitely had his presence felt down low. And when they needed a big bucket down the stretch, he was there to get it. He's been really money in the bank for them this year. And he's got a tremendous future for him. And he has a T-shirt to go along with it.
He is the Helena Chemical Player of the Game as Frontier wins it by a final score of 60-52 over Turner's Falls on the Greenfield Savings Bank scoreboard. Frontier now goes to 6-11 overall. They are 6-7 in league play, so they're almost back to 500 now in the Hampshire League. Turner's Falls now only a game over 500 in the Hampshire League at 6-5. They're now 10-5 overall. All right, that'll do it. Turner's Falls comes to town. They lose to Frontier, and the Red Hawks gain a season series split with the Indians with a 60-52 win. For Chris Collins and for Dave Reno, I'm Jeff Terrell. Thank you so much for joining us tonight, and have a great night in Bear Country, everyone.